Welcome to NetSet OS. In this video, we will try to solve a very famous problem, that is modular exponentiation. In previous video, we had seen an efficient, smarter method to solve power exponent, where we had two variables x and n. Now, modular exponentiation is the remainder, which we get by dividing x to the power of n with another variable, let's denote it by m, where x, n, and m are three positive integers. Let's understand this with the example where we have x as 7 and n as 2. Then we will take m as 5. So when we calculate this, 7 sevens are 49, modulus 5. That means here we will get 5. 49, 9s are 45 and 4 as a remainder. So easiest approach is to calculate 7 to the power of 2 first, then mod 5. Here, if we take to the power of n, it will reach to large values, apparently even for small values as well. Fortunately, we have laws of associativity, commutativity and distributivity. So we will use them to solve this problem. For example, let's delete this. So if we have a into b modulus m, this we can solve through a modulus m into b modulus m. And then completely modulus m. So for this, here we have this in outer, this will come first with a, then with b, and then collectively after a into b modulus m. So let's understand this with example. If we have here 7, b for 3, and here I'll take m for 5. When we simply calculate, it will be 21 mod 5, which will result to 1. Now, when we calculate using this right expression, I'll write RHS and LHS for this. A is equal to 7 mod 5 into b is 3. Mod 5 and collectively it will be mod 5. So 7 mod 5 is 2 into 3 mod 5 will be 3 and this will be collectively 5. So 3 2s are 6 mod 5 will be 1. That means LHS is equal to RHS. Now let's go to PyCharm for implementing this program. So for this, I'll make a new file over here with name recur underscore power underscore mod. Now we need to calculate x to the power of n. X to the power of n modulus m. So for this, as we understood in the last video, it can be called recursively by x into x to the power n minus 1 modulus m. So I can write here x modulus m first with first variable, then with second variable, which is x to the power of n minus 1, and then collectively after modulus m. Similarly, if we have even number, we can calculate it by x n by 2. Into x n by 2 modulus m. I can write x n by 2 modulus m, then the other one x n by 2 modulus m, and then collectively modulus m. So this is for even number. And this we got for odd number. Now, this recurrence relation is same as our last video, which we used to solve for x to the power of n. So let's make a program here. But before that, I should write in a proper way. So first of all, our base condition will come, where if n is equal to 0, it will be 1. If n is even, it will distribute to xn by 2 and then modulus m. And here it will come modulus m in collective as it is a n2. Then comes for odd number, x modulus m, x to the power of n minus 1 modulus m, then modulus m. Now we will make a new program with this, where we will write def mod underscore power. And here I'll take three variables, which are x, n, and then m. First, we need to take base condition, as base condition is very necessary for recursive program where our program terminates. Now I'll write if n is equal to 0, return 1. Elif, if n is even, so here I'll write n modulus 2 is equal to 0. It will return, but before that I need to write an expression which will be stored in result is equal to po of x and n by 2, power of x and n by 2, which will be represented by po, and here it will be mod m. So here it will return res, that stand for result, then res, and then collectively mod. Now we will see condition for odd number, which will be directly return x mod m into po of x n minus 1 mod m, and then collectively mod m. Then I need to call this. Here it will be 7, 5, let's say 3. And I need to print the value. So I'll write p is equal to and print p. So when I run this program, I got 1. Now I'll check with smaller values also, 2. And here when I run this, and when I validate this, 7 7s are 49, mod 3, it will be 1. So let's see how it works internally. Here we will take an example. Let's say x is equal to 7, n is equal to, let's take somewhat bigger, 8, and m will be 9. So when I'll calculate for 7 to the power of 8 mod 9, first it will check for n, whether n is equal to 0, no. So it will go to even number, as 8 is an even number. So here it will distribute into 2, 7 to the power 4 mod 9. Then again it will check n is equal to 4, which is an even number. Again, it will go to elif, and here it will distribute to 7 to the power 2 mod 9. And here, similarly for this also. Then again, it will check 2 is even. So here, again, it will distribute into 7 to the power 1 mod 9. And similarly, now 1 is odd. So here it will go to 7 into 7 to the power 0, then mod 9 and several. So here you can see we have distributed the whole program into singles. As it is 8, it will have just 4 recursive calls. So it will save our time and it will be order of log n. Though we will discuss this in an elaborative way, for this, time complexity is order of log n. So this gives us recursive Python program to calculate x to the power n mod m. Time complexity is order of log n, which is quite efficient. If you like my video, give a thumbs up and please do comment and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.
Thanks for watching.
Drop a like.
Leave a comment.
And don't forget to
subscribe.